latest BJP's poll campaign in Mizoram accuses successive state governments of diverting central funds. Scholars have a great role in shaping a society, but they were a failure in post-independence era, says Manipur Chief Minister. Asia-Europe meeting summit gets underway in Brussels. Vice President Venkaya Naidu leads Indian team. Mahanavami being celebrated all over Northeast with religious fervor. And 15-year-old Haryana boy Akash Malik becomes first Indian archer to win silver at Youth Olympics. Good evening and welcome to the Northeast News. This is Saraswati Singha wishing all our viewers a very happy Mahanavami Puja. And now the news in details. In news from poll-bound Mizoram first, BJP's National President Amit Shah launched his party's campaign in Aizawl on Wednesday. He not only inaugurated the party's state headquarters but also met several boot-level workers and tribal leaders. Addressing the boot-level workers at the state BJP headquarters in Aizawl, he launched a blistering attack against the ruling Congress. He charged that the money sent by the Centre for Mizoram's Development has been diverted through corrupt means. While the BJP is infusing its workers through boot-level conferences, the Congress suffered a setback in the run-up to the polls. Former State Minister Buddhadhan Chakma quit the party on Tuesday. In news from Manipur, Chief Minister N. Biren Singh today said the academicians and scholars have a great role in improving and shaping a society better. He said this at the launch function of the book Northeast India, A Reader, held at Darbar Hall, Chief Minister's Secretariat, Imphal. Speaking on the occasion, the Chief Minister said in the post-independence era, the intellectuals, academicians and scholars did not influence the politicians. Had forums and platforms like Manipur Research Forum existed at that time, the burning issues like ethnic conflict and unrest could have been avoided. He elaborately spoke on integrity and communal harmony in the state. Vice President M. Venkaya Naidu, who reached the Belgian capital on Wednesday night, will lead the Indian delegation at the two-day Asia-Europe meeting summit. The theme this year is Global Partners for Global Challenges. The summit will prioritize issues related to connectivity, trade and investment, sustainable development, climate change, terrorism, migration, maritime security and cyberspace. The meeting will bring together heads of state of 30 European and 21 Asian countries, besides top representatives of the European Union and Secretary General of the Association of Southeast Asian Nations. Apart from the opening ceremony, the Vice President will participate in the plenary session of this summit and have interactions with various stakeholders. Former Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Narayan Dutt Tiwari died at a private hospital in New Delhi today after prolonged illness, doctors said. He was 93. Tiwari was admitted at the Max Super Speciality Hospital and died at 2:50 p.m., the doctors said. The veteran leader also served as a union minister in several Congress governments and as the Andhra Pradesh governor. He also served as Uttarakhand chief minister. In Meghalaya, Health Minister A.L. Heck has said treatment by using medicinal plants and herbs should be integrated with scientific methods. Addressing media persons in Shillong after a meeting with traditional healers of the state on Wednesday, the minister said traditional medicine had existed in the state since time immemorial for treating various ailments and diseases. He, however, cautioned that such treatment should be done scientifically and in an organized manner to clear all doubts about the treatment. Heck said Kerala has progressed far ahead than others in treating patients of various diseases with traditional medicine by applying scientific knowledge.
First is, at least they have to do in a professional way. Now nobody is doing in a professional way, and few of them only, very negligible, they are doing in a professional way. The rest are all doing haphazardly. They are doing for the healing, for this all kind of the illness. So this is cannot be sustainable.
Today is Mahanavami of Durga Puja. Devotees strong puja pandals across Assam right from the morning. At midday, long queues were seen in many pandals when devotees turned up to offer anjali to Goddess Durga and seek her blessings. Animals including buffaloes were sacrificed in Ugratara Temple in Guwahati, Bilbeshwar Temple in Nolbari and other temples in Upper Assam. A pleasant weather has proved to be a boost for the puja revelers. The crowds were relatively thin during the morning hours but grew bigger as the afternoon and evening approached. There are more than 4,000 puja pandals in this day. In Tripura, the Mahanavami was celebrated today at Durgabari, Agartala, with old-age tradition of buffalo sacrifice. Along with the young buffalo, many goats and pigeons were also sacrificed as part of the rituals. Chief Minister of Tripura, Biplab Kumar Dev, visited the temple this morning and paid his obeisance to Goddess Durga. The century-old Royal Durgabari Temple of Agartala has always remained a prime focus of devotees and visitors during Durga Puja. The temple is run by the government of Tripura. The idol of the temple is also of a different kind, where Durga has only two hands visible while the remaining eight are hidden behind her back. In Arunachal Pradesh, Durga Puja is being celebrated with great religious fervor and gaiety. In capital Itanagar, people from all sections of the society throng puja pandals for evening prayers. Besides, Durga Ashtami is also being celebrated in Nagar Lagoon and Nirjuli areas of capital complex. Cultural programs are also being organized on the occasion. Immersion of idols will take place tomorrow. In Manipur, thousands of devotees from across the state throng Hyangthang Lairimbi Temple at Hyangthang under Imphal West District on the occasion of Boar Prayer on Wednesday. Since early morning, a large number of people gathered outside the temple complex waiting for their turn to get inside where Sandhya Puja of Mera was offered. Manipur Deputy Chief Minister Vijoy Kumar Singh and PD Minister Karam Shyam were among those who offered prayer on the occasion. Today is Kati Bihu, also called Kongali. The festival is one of the three Bihus of Assam. People across the state lit an earthen lamp at the base of the Tulsi plant in the household premises and offered prayers. In some villages, Naam Kirtans were organized. Lamps were also lit in some paddy fields.
পানী দি হলা ধুনা চাকি সেইবিলাক দি শৰাই লৈ আকৌ পথাৰত আহিছোঁ আৰু অইনবাৰৰ নিচিনাকৈ এইবাৰো শলা চাকি দিবৰ কাৰণে যাতে পোক পৰুৱাই আমাৰ ধানখিনি নষ্ট নকৰে.
In sports news, Akash Malik became India's first silver medalist in archery at the Youth Olympic Games being held in Buenos Aires, Argentina. The 15-year-old son of a farmer lost a one-sided final to Trenton Culls of the USA 06 as India concluded the Youth Olympics with 3 gold, 9 silver and 1 bronze. Seeded 5th after qualification, the Haryana boy was inconsistent in the summit clash against the 15th seed Culls, who only shot in 10s and 9s to wrap it up easily on Wednesday night. In the 3-setter, both the archers shot 4 perfect 10s, but Akash's 2 wayward 6s in the first and the third set proved to be the decisive factor. The Union government today denied media reports that 50 crore mobile numbers are at the risk of disconnection. In a joint statement in New Delhi, the Department of Telecommunications and the Unique Identification Authority of India has said the report is baseless. The statement said an unnecessary panic has been created among mobile users. It also clarified that Supreme Court in its judgment has not said that mobile numbers acquired through Aadhaar cards have to be disconnected. In Manipur, Minister of Health and Family Welfare L. Jayantikumar Singh on Wednesday unveiled the memorial stone of Anglo-Kuki war heroes at General Tintong Memorial Complex at Songpi Village, Chirachandpur. Speaking as chief guest at the formal program held at KIC Complex, Tuvong, the minister called upon the people not to succumb to outside forces and just be Kukis. Fragmentation or division among different tribes will not help, he added.
We should never succumb to any pressure from outside. Bapa ni kita lakukan ganggu sini pressure dapat succumb dalam waktu berhenti.
And finally, in Meghalaya, the farmers in southwest Khasi Hills district have recently suffered a great loss as their rice crops were damaged by insects. In Mokirot, many farmers complained that their rice crops ready for harvest were damaged by the insects. Mayang Linkoy, president of the Hill Farmer Union Southwest Khasi Hills, said they have already taken up the matter with the agriculture department and have sought necessary assistance to deal with the matter. Before winding up the headlines once again, Amit Shah launches BJP's poll campaign in Mizoram, accuses successive state governments of diverting central funds. Scholars have a great role in shaping a society, but they were a failure in post-independence era, says Manipur Chief Minister. Asia-Europe meeting summit gets underway in Brussels. Vice President Venkaiya Naidu leads Indian team. Mahanavami being celebrated all over Northeast with religious fervor. And 15-year-old Haryana boy Akash Malik becomes first Indian archer to win silver at Youth Olympics. That brings us to the end of this evening's bulletin. Thank you for tuning in. Namaskar.